neck type of the antenna, which is called as the Yagi-Uda type of the antenna. From this video we will discuss about that, the introduction of the Yagi-Uda antenna, its principle, construction, working, its picture of an antenna, advantages and disadvantages of an antenna. Then what is the introduction? In case of the introduction, the Yagi-Uda antenna or Yagi antenna is the one of the most brilliant antenna design. It is the simple to construct and it has the high gain. Typically it will be greater than 10 dB. The Yagi-Uda antenna is typically operate in the high frequency and ultra high frequency bands, and it will be designed in the frequency range of 3 MHz to 3 GHz, and it will be covered to 40 to 60 km. Basically the directional antenna system consisting of an array of coupled parallel dipole type of the antenna, and this is commonly known as the Yagi-Uda or simply Yagi antenna. From this picture we have understand that what is the actual design on practically the Yagi-Uda type of the antenna. On the left hand side, the scientist of Yagi-Uda is able to develop this type of the antenna for the communication purpose, and where on the right hand side too shows that there is a booster is available because to maintain the strength of the signal of an antenna. Then what is the principle behind it? The Yagi-Uda antenna is an electromagnetic device that collects the radio waves. An antenna is attuned to the particular frequency will resonate to a radio signal of the same frequency. This is the principle of the Yagi-Uda antenna. The construction, from the construction it will be shows that there are the different sections, and based upon that sections this antenna is operative. Here is the reflector, basically the folded dipole of antenna. The folded dipole antenna, it will be acting as the reflector. Then where actually the balloon type of the antenna is able to place, which is called as the driven element, and remaining all are the multiple directors. There are three types of the element. In that three types of the element, first element is the reflector, second is the driven element, and third is the multiple directors. Then in case of the construction, the driven element, of the Yagi is the feed point, where the feed line is attached from the transmitter to the Yagi to perform the transfer of power from transmitter to the antenna, and the dipole driven element will be resonant when its electrical length is the half of the wavelength of the frequency applied to its the feed point. And the feed point in the picture above is on the center of the driven element. The construction, in case of the construction, the director is the shortest of the parametric element, and this ends of the Yagi element is attuned to the director is the shortest of the parametric element, and this ends of the Yagi element is aimed at the receiving station, and it is the resonance slightly higher in the frequency than the driving element, and its length will be about the 5% of the shorter, and it will be progressively that the driving element. The director length can be varied depending upon the director spacing, and the number of the directors will be used in the antenna, and the desired pattern bandwidth, and the element diameters which is able to use it. Then in the director, in case of here, from this antenna, basically the director is the shortest of the parapetry element. And this end of the Yagi is element at the receiving station. It is resonantly slightly higher in the frequency that can be driving element, and its length will be about the 5% shorter progressively than the driving element. The director's length can be varied depending upon the director spacing and the number of the directors used in the antenna, and the design pattern bandwidth, and the element diameter. Then the amount of the gain is directly proportional to the length of the antenna array, and not by the number of the directors which is to be used. Then reflector, what is the function of the reflector? In case of the reflector is the element that is placed at the rear of its driving element, and its resonant frequency is lower, and its length is approximately 5% longer than the driving. The resonant frequency is lower and its length is approximately 5% longer than the driving element. Its length is very depending on the spacing and the element diameter. The spacing of the reflector, basically here is the spacing between the reflector, reflector will be between the 1 and wavelength and its 0.5 wavelength, and its spacing depend upon the gain bandwidth and its front to back ratio and the side lobe pattern requirement for the final antenna. Basically the reflector here, here is the working we have seen here, after that the working, and for their working the reflector here the drives its main power from the driver, and it reduces the signal strength in its own directions, and thus the reflection and the radiation towards the driver and the directors. The driving element is the where the signal is the intercepted by the receiving equipment and has a cable attached that takes the received signal to the receiver, and the radiator and the driver can be placed more closer to increase the radiation length towards the director. Then its wavelength should be calculated 3 × 10⁸ meter per second upon its frequency in megahertz. It's basically wavelength which is equal to 3 × 10⁸ upon frequency, and to determine the wavelength of the radio station with the frequency of the 92.1 megahertz, simply divide the speed of the light by 92,100 cycles per second. Second cancels out the formula given the wavelength ending at the 3.26 meter. The other words, the wave is passing by right now from a radio station transmitting at the 92.1 megahertz or 326 meters long. Then 5 element Yagi-Uda antenna. From that 5 element Yagi-Uda antenna, there is the one reflector here which is to be placed in X, Y and Z axis as usual. The reflector, the element number 1 is the reflector, and there is the element number 2 which is placed along the Z axis, which is called as the driver, and the remaining are the directors. Okay, then here is to show the geometry of the Yagi-Uda antenna. Then radiation pattern by the directional antenna at one particular direction, it is along the y axis to show the direction of the main beam. Then radiation pattern formed by the directional antenna. For here, the antenna exhibits the directional pattern consisting of the main forward lobe and the number of the spurious side lobes. The main one of these is the reverse lobe caused by the radiation in the direction of the reflector, and the antenna can be optimized to either to reduce this or produce the maximum level of the forward gain. Here is the picture of the actual antenna. There is the 11 element of the Yagi-Uda antenna. There are 11 number of the elements which is to be formed, and most of the element which is to the forward direction of an antenna. Then in this antenna, for this type of the antenna is able to use for the TV signal reception, and the Yagi antenna is particularly useful to form the RF antenna design, and it is widely used in the application where the RF antenna design is required to provide gain and directivity. And in this way, the optimum transmission and reception condition can be obtained. Then here is the picture of the antenna in a radar system, and for that radar system the gain should be designed where G which is equal to 69. Its advantages is that it has the moderate gain of the antenna, about the 7 dB. It is the directional antenna that can be used for the high frequency, adjustable from front to back ratio. Disadvantages is that the gain is not a very high, and it needs a large number of the elements. Its application about that, the Yagi-Uda antenna is the unidirectional antenna used for the television receivers, and they provide a better tuning because of the large bandwidth and had decent gain. Thanks.
Good afternoon, one and all. Today we will going to discuss about the